Okay, I'll give you the explanations of why anyone has to be tied to me about why I have this conversation with you. First of all, I said I was a clinical prosthetist and an orthotist. A prosthetist is a medical practitioner that makes artificial parts of the body. And an orthotist is also a medical practitioner that augments weak parts of the body. So I make artificial parts of the body and I augment weak parts of the body. And I've been doing this for over 7 years, and I've worked with lots and lots of physically disabled people. Today, I want to be having a conversation with you all about the topic that I call being differently abled in the new world. So I've carefully listened to how amazing all the conversations here have been today, where everybody's talking about their ideas in this new world. And I'm here to just point out a big bunch of people that we don't know or we don't pay attention to, but yeah, they make up a big part of our society. These people are the disabled people. So that's why I'm getting my hands tied up. So you see, I have my hands tied to my back, assuming that I don't have both hands. I'm still talking to you and you're still listening. Because being physically challenged doesn't affect your mind. It just means you're losing a part of the body. Or losing a part of your body, or having a less functional part of the body, doesn't make you less human. You're a human being. The guy that doesn't have both legs is also a human being. The guy that doesn't have both hands is also a human being like you. The guy that can't see or that's having a visual problem, it's also a human being like you. The deaf guy, it's also a human being. So there's not like full human and half human. We're just human beings. And that's the conversation that I would love to drive today. Okay, here's it. I want to talk a few numbers. I hope the slides are up. Can I get to the next slide? Okay, that's fine. So go back. Now the reason I put the page, I screenshot the page from Google was so you see that you know that these numbers were not coming from me, it was from Google. Now, according to the United Nations, there are 600 million persons living with disabilities. That's over half a billion. They are enough to start a continent. Now, in these 600 million people that live with disabilities around the world, of whom 400 million of them live in developing countries. I won't call names of countries, but now 80 million of these disabled persons live in Africa. And guess what? According to the World Health Organization, we have 25 million disabled people in Nigeria. So here's the conversation. If you have 25 million people in Nigeria, what's the population of Ghana? It means that the disabled people in Nigeria is more than every single person in Ghana. It means that the disabled people in Nigeria is more than, I think, Denmark. It's more than some European countries. Just the disabled people in Nigeria. And how are we paying attention to them? So you see, every one of us here has seen a disabled person. True or false?
True.
That time when you saw that disabled guy, or you saw the disabled girl, what were the thoughts that went through your mind? Oh yeah? Somebody said pity. You see, that pity thought you had, what did you do for the person? Did you say sorry to the person? So when you said sorry, let's say I get 1,000 sorries. What is 1,000 sorry going to do for me as a guy without both hands? So that's the conversation I want us to be having this today. How do we see physically challenged persons in our country? Do we see them for their disabilities, or we need to start seeing them for their abilities? With no disrespect to anybody, how many of us know Kobams? Everybody knows Kobams, right?
Yeah.
With no disrespect to anybody, do you know Kobams' driver? Oh, he's got two eyes. That's the conversation. You see how we know a blind guy, but we don't know the other guy with two eyes. Not because it's more important. Nobody is more important than each other. So this brings me to a story that I'm about to tell you all. I own a clinic in Abuja, and I own another clinic in Port Harcourt. So I was in my clinic in Port Harcourt, and this particular patient, for some reason, wanted to come to Port Harcourt. So he flew into Port Harcourt. He didn't want to wait for me to come to Abuja. Got in a taxi and was coming to the clinic. I've had a conversation with this guy. First, for patient privacy, I would call him patient X. And he's in a taxi with this taxi driver, coming down to the clinic, and they had like interesting conversations that I don't know what they might have been talking about, but their conversation was interesting and caught it to me. But patient X is 38 years old, he's a PhD holder, and lecturer in one of the Nigerian universities. Then he comes into the clinic because of the conversation he's been having with the driver on their way coming from the airport to the clinic. For some reason, he lets the driver come into the clinic with him to wait for him to take him to a hotel after he gives a complaint about his problem, or his challenge. Sorry, this is a problem. And the driver steps into the clinic with him. For some reason, he just connects with the driver and he chooses that the driver come into my office with him. And the driver comes into the office and is feeling, oh, I just made a new friend. And this guy pulls up his belt buckle and pulls his trousers down. And he's in a move near empty. He doesn't have one leg. And guess what the driver says? Oh my God. He gets people way I better pass. Now this, with no disrespect to anybody, let's have a conversation. A driver and a 36-year-old PhD holder. Was that an intelligent thing for the driver to say with no disrespect to him? So that's the conversation. So if a blind guy like Kobams can pick Kobams and everybody says Kobams and you know who Kobams is, if Mr. X could be a PhD holder and still be an amputee, the question is, how are you seeing differently able people? Like, I want us to start seeing them from today, not disabled persons, differently able. Because they don't have hands, they don't have legs, they have problems with their eyes, but they are still human beings. They're just differently able. So the conversation here again is, how do you respond to these people when you see them? What's the thought that goes through your head? The way you behave when you see a disabled person, the people around you are reading your body language. When they behave that way to a disabled person and you're watching it, will you be happy that you made somebody behave that way? What has your cheya and your sorry done for the disabled people in our society? Can we start looking at them as not our problems? Can we stop having so much empathy and pity on these people and start seeing them for who they are? I'll give you a simple example. Here we are on this TEDx stage, an amazing event, TEDx Kinibu Bell. Organizers did very well, all the guys. But nobody made plans for the guy that's in the wheelchair to come on this stage. Isn't that fair? Is that fair? Nobody made plans for a blind guy down there to be able to fill the form by himself. Does that make sense? Are there no blind people in Kinibu? Are there no people on wheelchairs in Kinibu? I don't think the conversation is beginning to sink in. How do you respond or how do you behave when you see physically challenged persons or differently able persons? It will help. So here's what I have to propose. Rather than see them as pity, why don't you start seeing their abilities? Do you know the market, 25 million of them are in Nigeria? Hey, tech guy, what kind of technology are you building and you're not thinking about this 25 million? Do you know the market of 25 million people? Hey, fashionista, are you making a gown for a girl that doesn't have a leg? Are you thinking about a girl that doesn't have a hand? Are you making something for her? Hey, engineer, the next time you're building a house, are you thinking about how a blind guy is going to be able to come into the house without knowing people, without being helped? Are you thinking about the guy with a wheelchair being able to come into that building, into the building that you're building? If you're not doing that, then what are you doing to make this new world a better place? Are you not contributing to the problem of our new world? Beg you all to start paying attention to people.